Hello, and welcome to the Precision Lab series for temperature sensors. In this video, we'll be discussing some of the general challenges in designing for accuracy. Contained in this video, we'll start with a general discussion of some misunderstandings we often hear concerning terminologies and interpreting data sheets for NTC thermistors and IC temperature sensors. Following this, we'll be discussing factors that must be considered in a board design to maximize the accuracy of the measurement. So let's get started with a review of some basic terminologies. When it comes to accuracy of a temperature sensor, it's probably the most important factor, yet often the most misunderstood, especially when it comes to interpreting a data sheet. Before we dive into that, let's have a quick recap of the terminology. While often used interchangeably, accuracy is not the same as precision. Precision is the repeatability of a measurement, but may not necessarily be accurate. An accurate temperature sensor must be precise, but also match the results to an international standards body, such as NIST, which is the National Institute of Standards and Technology, or to an equivalent local standards body. Another misconception we often hear is a mix-up between accuracy and the resolution of the ADC. A higher resolution simply provides more granularity in the measurement. However, it does not imply precision or accuracy. Now that we're clear on terminologies, let's take a look at some data sheets and see what's really being defined. The most common misconception with accuracy is often with NTC thermistors. We hear often that a design is getting 1% accuracy with a thermistor. However, this is usually not the case. So let's dive into where that 1% comes from and what it actually means. Where the misconception usually comes from is how to interpret the tolerance in the NTC's datasheet. The assumption is that a 1% tolerance translates to a 1% measurement accuracy. 1% simply refers to the expected variability in resistance. So for a 10K NTC, it could be plus or minus 100 ohms. How much error that translates to will depend upon the actual temperature resistance relationship for that thermistor. It's important to note that 1% tolerance in the resistance is only defined at 25C and could vary across temperature. Another consideration from the NTC's data sheet that must be accounted for is the variability in the thermistor's curvature. This is described in the data sheet as the beta tolerance between two temperature points. As seen on the chart on the right, the variability can have significant impact on the measured resistance as the temperature moves further away from 25C. When it comes to thermistors, it's also very important to examine the complete circuitry to understand the actual accuracy that can be achieved. In a typical voltage divider topology, the achieved accuracy will also be dependent on the bias resistor, its tolerance, and how much that resistor drifts with temperature as well. If tied directly to the supply, any supply noise will also be passed through to the thermistor reading. It's also necessary to take a look at the error contribution of the ADC and any additional amplifiers in the circuit. The natural curvature of the NTC creates the next set of challenges in determining the measurement accuracy. Its nonlinear nature introduces additional mathematical error in the resistance to temperature conversion. Also at high temperature, the slope flattens significantly, posing a challenge for the ADC. A NTC's lack of sensitivity in this range results in a loss of resolution for the ADC, thus contributing to quantization error in the measurement. However, these contributing errors can be minimized with a linear thermistor, such as TI's TMP61 family. For more information on ADCs and amplifier error, please be sure to check out the Precision Lab series on those as well. Let's move on to IC temperature sensors. One of the benefits of an IC temperature sensor is that it does provide a defined temperature accuracy across a broad temperature range. In most data sheets, you'll see two values listed, a typical accuracy and a max accuracy. Typical is exactly that. Typical represents the expected accuracy that will be achieved for any given unit. Max is the worst case value. To ensure enough design margin, it is recommended to follow the max spec. When comparing data sheets, it's important to note which value is being listed, typical or max. The linear nature of an IC sensor also dramatically reduces the linearization error and isn't prone to the quantization error at high temperatures compared to an NTC. For a digital temperature sensor where the ADC is integrated, all these errors are already factored into the device's typical and max accuracy spec. Lastly, IC temperature sensors can provide over a 10x improvement in the power consumption compared to an NTC, thus dramatically reducing the measurement error due to self-heating. After selecting your temperature sensor, it's critical to consider the board layout and placement of the temperature sensor. Even the best temperature sensor will be error-prone with a poor layout. When starting a board layout, there's four factors that must be considered to maintain the accuracy of the temperature sensor. First, clearly understand the measurement objective, as this greatly determines how the board should be laid out. Designing a PCB for measuring ambient temperature will be very different than monitoring the temperature of an FPGA or monitoring a person's body temperature. Second, understand all the thermal pathways around the sensor. This means looking at all the conductive paths where heat is gained or lost through PCB traces, the ground plane, or the board material itself. It's also important to think about the airflow in the system. Even without an active fan moving air, heat from other circuitry will generate convective air currents, which could draw heat towards or away from the sensor. Often overlooked is the impact of radiative sources. Even a hot heat sink on the opposite side of the system will contribute to heating the temperature sensor if there is line of sight. Third is to manage the thermal resistance. The goal here is to minimize the thermal resistance between the sensor and the target object, while trying to maximize the resistance to other heat sources that could negatively impact the accuracy of the measurement. This is where a lot of tricks can be employed in not only where the sensor is placed, but adding or removing metal depending on the objective. Last, it's important to reduce the thermal mass around the sensor. This can dramatically improve the thermal response time between the sensor and the target, reducing the error caused by the lag time in the sensor reaching equilibrium with the target. It's important here to not only select a small sensor for a faster response, but also to manage the thermal mass of the PCB surrounding the temperature sensor. Now, let's take a look at the following example. Here we have a simple PCB, where we'd like to design the board to measure the ambient air temperature. For simplicity's sake in this example, we'll say there's one primary heat source on the board, which is the MCU. Additionally, fresh airflow from the outside of the system is coming in from the left side of the PCB. This may be from an active fan or just passive airflow through the system due to stack effect. Here, the logical location to meet our objective of measuring the ambient air temperature is to place the sensor in the corner, maximizing the distance from the MCU heat source while close to the fresh air before it's been heated up by the circuitry in the system. Next, we'll take a look at the thermal resistance. With the high thermal conductivity of copper PCB traces, we'll want to reduce any heat that may come from the MCU. Depending on the size of the PCB, this could mean increasing the trace length or narrowing the width of the traces, thus increasing the thermal resistance between the sensor and the hot MCU. We also need to consider the heat conducted through the PCB itself and what can be done to increase the thermal resistance between the temperature sensor and the hot MCU. One trick is to not extend the PCB's ground plane all the way to the temperature sensor, thus reducing the heat spread from the MCU. Lastly, to improve the accuracy and thermal response time of the air temperature measurement, it's important to consider reducing the thermal mass around the sensor. While you may have already selected a small temperature sensor with minimal thermal mass, the PCB itself will essentially act as a large heat sink, slowing response time. A trick to minimize this is to place cuts in the PCB, thus reducing the thermal mass around the sensor that needs to be warmed or cooled to equilibrium with the air. Thank you for watching, and be sure to check out some of our other resources and products at ti.com/temperature.